It's a discovery. You must settle down. Let me start with the last verse. In verse 27, the Bible says, while the servants were moving with Saul, can you watch this now? As the servants were moving with Saul, it says, Samuel said to the servant, go ahead and Saul, stay with me. Let me give you a word from God. Does that make sense to you? He said, go ahead, servants, go ahead. And you, Saul, stay back. Let me give you a word from God. Please, I beg you, don't be panicked. Don't be shaken. When some people are going ahead of you now, they might just be your servants very soon. When some people are in front of you now, they might just be your servants very soon. Stay back with a word from God. Maybe the man has bought a jeep. Let him go ahead. You are staying back with God. Maybe he has built a bigger church. Let him go ahead. You are staying back with God. I don't know who is ahead of you. If you can stay back with God, those who have gone ahead, we end up being servants. Listen, when what is keeping you from doing what they are doing illegally is the word of the Lord, they will turn out to be your servants very soon. I don't mean you are staying back because you are lazy. I don't mean you are staying back because you are prayerless. You are staying back because there are things they are doing that you refuse to do. There are compromise you refuse to compromise. And they are buying cars. They are going to a different country. They are doing different. Get ready. Because those that appear to be in front of you, very soon, they will end up as your servants. Am I talking to somebody here? God has sent me to tell you, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not. It doesn't matter who has gone ahead of you. Now, do you know why? How can you tell my servant to go ahead? You didn't get that. How can you tell my servant to go ahead? I am not envious. Why was he not envious? A mentor was sitting with him. A mentor was sitting with him. He told him, he said, see this one? They are all in a hurry now. They are going ahead. They are servants. I will show you the word of the Lord. When I show you the word of the Lord, those who have gone ahead of you, once you contact insight, overtaking is allowed. I said, once you contact insight, I prophesy with this mouth that I used to pray. There is someone hearing the sound of my voice. I don't know where you came from. Maybe you came from America. Yeah. You came from London. Oh. You came from New Zealand. Oh. You came from Australia. Oh. You came from Dubai. Yeah. You came from South Africa. Yeah. You came from Botswana. You came from Ghana. You came from Cameroon. You came from Togo. You came from Libya. You came from Liberia. You came from Sierra Leone. You came from Republic of Benin. You came from Cote d'Ivoire. I don't know where you came from. Oh. I prophesy. Yeah. I reason of the word of the Lord. Oh. Those who have gone ahead of you, you are about to overtake them. In that same land, not in another country, in that same land. Oh boy, nobody's hearing me. In that same land, when a word was spoken in the Garden of Eden, God placed a curse. He placed a curse on Adam and he said, Adam, out of the sweat of thy brow thou shalt eat bread. He said, thou shalt labor. Work was not the curse. It was sweat that was the curse in the Garden of Eden. So when Jesus wanted to change it, he entered another garden called Gethsemane. And as he began to pray, sweat came out of him. But this time his own sweat was stronger. It was like blood. What was he saying? The curse on Adam, by prayer, I have taken it away. I prayed before I came. I prayed before I got here. I came to tell you, if there was a curse in the Garden of Eden, there is another blessing in the Garden of Gethsemane. Oh. What is Gethsemane? Gethsemane means oil press. When oil is pressed, oil flow. After now, oil will flow. Hey. Over your life and ministry, oil will flow. Hey. I say, oil will flow. Hey. Lift up your eyes and shout hallelujah. Oh. Listen, take your seat.
Take your seat.
The search
for the throne. What was missing? Asses. Asses were missing. What's an ass? That's a baby lamb. Is that true? An ass is a baby lamb. It was missing. Why not a lamb? Why not a sheep? If a man has a sheep and a lamb, why will he look for as a baby lamb? Now, watch me. When Jesus Christ, the Bible says, he sent them, he said, there's a celebration coming. You will go somewhere, you will see an ass tied in a place where two ways met, right? The ass was strategically tied. What would you do with an ass? You should ask for a donkey. You want the celebration. Will you kill a little ass to celebrate? Do you know, if you watch that story, when they say lose him and bring him, after that, they brought it. There was no news of it. If you see the Lord has need of it, we expected you to use it as you brought it. It was at the infancy stage. And I was asking God, I said, God, why a baby ass? And God began to talk to me that most people on earth, their lives got corrupted at their infancy stage. Most people on earth, their life and their struggle dates back to their foundation. Most pastors are suffering because of their foundational battles of life. It's not the building, it's the foundation. And as I began to pray, God spoke to me. He said, the asses we are missing, he identified what was wrong. You can never conclude a search until you know what is missing. There is something in your location that is missing. Am I talking to somebody here? When I came to this place, I got to Auchi years ago. Listen to me. If you come from Abuja, Port Harcourt, Lagos, wherever you come from, Niger, any city you come from, and things are happening, it is normal. I am not just in a small location. It's my hometown. Go to your hometown and produce results. They will listen. Go to your hometown and do ministry there and bring this kind of result that we are seeing in a town that is just 60,000 people, including dogs. Am I communicating here?
But I came with the word of the Lord, and God said, go, for I am with you. And I said, what do I am myself? He said, arm yourself with power. Except they see signs, they will not believe. Am I talking to somebody here? I came to announce to somebody. Can I initiate you? A pastor called me this morning. He said, have you heard the rumors? What rumor? He said, they said you are the head of all the secret cults. What is that? Campus. Black Axe. Is it campus cult? Black Axe. So they said you are the head of all the campus cults in Edo State. Is it true? I say yes. He said, ah, sir, campus court? I say yes, because my father is the head of principalities and powers. Am I talking to somebody here? And the man said to me, if it takes joining a cult like this for souls to be saved, he said, man of God, we have to talk. And I said to him, I said, I will give you form so that you will join. I said, the form, before you get it, you speak in tongues for 10 hours before I give you the form. Can I initiate you? I want to initiate somebody. You know what David said? He said, when the spirit possessed me, that's somebody I am possessed.
I am possessed.
He said, this kind of thing happening now can happen to somebody has joined something. I want to initiate someone into the company of those that we pray without ceasing. I want to initiate someone into the company of those whose garment will not be stained. I want to initiate somebody into the company of favor carriers. I want to initiate someone into the generation of kingdom treasurers. I want to initiate somebody into a generation of those that will walk without blemish, without spot, without wrinkle. And I prophesy, if anyone failed around you, you are excluded. Failure cannot see you anymore. I prophesy upon your life by the power of the Holy Spirit. Everything you have seen here that you desire, carry it for your ministry. Carry it for your life. Carry it for your life. Carry it for your ministry. Carry it for your life.
Amen.
Listen. 3 days. 3 days. 3 days back, I saw a number. A number from Germany. He kept calling. So I picked and I said, please, can you send me a text? He said, Dad, I'm a pastor. And he mentioned his name. I said, oh, where have you been? He said, please forgive me. He did something some years ago. He said, forgive me what I did years ago. I said, forget what you did. I can't even remember what you did. Where have you been? Why have I not been seeing you? And he said to me, there's a situation now. He said, my assistant pastor, they just took him away. I'm actually driving behind them. The police took him and they're about taking, he's handcuffed and they are taking him to the plane. I said, what did you do? He said, his paper just expired. We are actually trying to renew it. I said, so you are seeing him go? He said, yes. I said, they will turn him back. He said, sir, you don't understand. He's in the car. I said, they will turn him back. Hold on. Less than 3 minutes. He said, the car they were using to carry him broke down. They pulled over. Europe police car breakdown. They pulled over. They were there sweating. And they now told him, they said, we have to put in another car. Now, you have to be stupid to do this kind of thing. They put him in the car behind him, which was this my son's home, and told him to go to the airport and wait for them. If not you, you go, go! The guy said he came down. He said, but my hands are cuffed. So they loosened the handcuff, gave him the handcuff and the key. That he should cuff himself when he get there and sit where they will meet him. He said, I'm here. So the young man called me, said, Papa, he's in my car now. I said, your car, what happened? And he told me the story. He said, but I don't want to be implicated. I said, I've implicated you already. Look for a place and reverse and go home. Am I talking to somebody? God is about to suspend the senses. I said, God, listen, anyone that has conspired is about to approve against you. When they're about to sign what we undo you, they will sign what we bless you. Can I tell you what God is telling me? Whoever wants to give you a quit notice will give you a check. Use them to favor you. Amen. God will use them to favor you. Lift your hand, shout fire.
Fire.
Take your seats. Monde Libra Gadabas.
There are challenges of life.
Listen. There are challenges and pains. And that's why I tell people, convert your pain to power. Don't go through pain in vain. John the beloved never saw revelation while he was close to Jesus. While he was close to Jesus, John the beloved never saw revelation. He only saw revelation in the island of Patmos. Sometimes comfortability can affect spirituality.
He was close to Jesus until he entered an island of wild beasts, wild animals. That was why Paul said, the bulls of Bashan have surrounded me. The wicked bulls of Bashan have surrounded me. But I like what he said. He said, they will not overtake me. I don't know the challenges of your life. The bulls of Bashan may surround you. The bulls of Bashan may throw arrows at you. But they will not overtake you. It's a command of emotion. I like what the Bible says in Isaiah 59 and verse 19. So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and is going down from the rising of the sun. For when the enemy shall come like a flood, when financial trouble shall come like a flood, when trials shall come like a flood, when sickness shall come like a flood, the spirit of the Lord
a standard against them. Lift your hand, shout fire.
Fire.
The search for a throne. Tell somebody, I'm on a search. Take your seat. Success is not a destination, it's a discovery. Success in life, success in ministry is not a destination, it's a discovery. Went to Ephraim, from Ephraim he went to Shalisha. He passed through all of those and never saw the missing asses. What is Shalisha? Third party. The meaning of Shalisha is a third party. If you are looking for greatness in destiny, you must know God for yourself, not from a third party. The God of your mentor cannot work for you until you have first known him personally. He knew the God of Elijah personally before he said, where is he? The God of Elijah only respects the Elijahs of God. Until you first have a personal revelation with him, that is when the man he has put over your life begins to manifest in your direction in the form of dreams and all that. Now they passed through the islands. They were searching. You apply passion. Searching involves motion. Searching involves resources. Resource. You can't fail after now. You have no choice. You can't fail. Tell somebody, it's not possible. I can't fail. We went through Shalisha, couldn't find it. They went through Shalim. What is Shalim? Little foxes. If you study Songs of Solomon chapter 2 verse 15, he said, yeah, ye the little foxes that have spoiled the vine, for our vine are of tender grapes. The little foxes that spoil the vine. Hallelujah. There are challenges in life you go through. Please, I want to beg you. You know, when I read about Esau one time, I was laughing. Esau had a personal problem. It wasn't porridge. Because what hunger will kill a man in the morning? The day has not ended. What hunger will kill a man in the morning? It was just somebody who wanted to have his way. If you study later, Esau had two wives at a young age. And he married women. Bible says, the Bible used the word, women from open country. Lose women that you don't pay bride price. He always wanted the easy way out. From the open country, no bride price. He was an immediate man. Wanted now. When you go for the immediate, you miss the ultimate. He married women from an open country. And don't forget, by then, Abraham had said that none of his children should marry from Cana. That's where he went to. Why? They were free wives. No bride price. Loose, fancy free, foot loose.
So his problem that he had was a personal problem. The little foxes that have spoiled the vine.
And we pastors today have empowered people with foxes. Let me say this to you. Can I say this? Paul's encounter on his way to Damascus was not a full definition of the gospel. If it were some of us that were around Paul, would have told him to confess on the tip. You hear what I said? Confess that how you saw light, how you were a killer. Confess that you killed Christians. As a matter of fact, the tape will sell faster because it was known to be notorious. Not someone hiding from somewhere. Known to be notorious. A singular encounter is not the gospel. A personal encounter is not the gospel. The gospel is about Christ. That you died and went to hell is not the gospel. That you saw heaven is not the gospel. No scripture is of private interpretation.
not the gospel. Some young girl years ago said she was in this town for 3 years. I was a mission to kill me. She said all kinds of things. She wanted to kill me. She has been to my office several times. She has tried this, tried that. One time, while she was going, I said, turn at the door. I said, the gates of the church is still open for you. You can give your life to Christ. Said many things. Said a lot of scary things. At one time, they came like wind. I was living in the former house before I moved to where I live now. Now they came like wind. They were about to penetrate to the kitchen to meet my wife. And the wind blew all up. She said all kinds of things that members would have been jumping to hear. He said, I want to confess. I said, no. Stay in church. Hear the word. So that the faith of my people does not rest on the wisdom of men, but on the power of God. It does not become an explanation of me, a private interpretation, but on the power. There are some tapes you should not listen to. Listen to the Bible. There are some things you should not be interested in hearing about. Am I communicating? You died, went to heaven, went to hell, and you are busy confessing different places and charging people. No Bible quotation. No scriptural reference. Man, watch, because that thing has stopped for a while now. Somebody will soon die now. Somebody is dying very soon. Somebody will die very soon and go and come and confess again. That time, they may not call men of God. They may call some other things. Call some politicians that they saw in hell. No, just give it. Give the script some spice and all that. You know, am I talking to somebody right now? And many of us, with the church, I have said this over time. If you ask a student something or teach a student something, he will go back to the library to go and research and find out if it's like that. If you tell a medical student something, he will go back and bring medical apparatus and he will find out. But anything you tell a church, we just believe. We just buy. You are being taught what is not real. The Berean Christian, we are more noble than the Christians in Thessalonica, for they received the word of God with all readiness of heart and went back home and searched. Acts 15:11. If these things were so. Pastor was casting out a demon from a girl. Name, come out of her. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. The demon says, shh. Every knee should bow. Not Shaba, should bow. The demon did the Bible study for a man of God. He said, every knee should bow. A demon was talking. Every knee should bow. I want people. Why am I at points of my life, I'm not able to sit down? My wife is here. She can tell you. There is nothing material that I value. She can tell you nothing. Show me a house that's big. Say, okay. Are you serious? This belongs to us? Wow. I'm cracking my head. Lord, when am I sowing this thing as a seed? When, Lord? When, Lord? When? When? When am I sowing? When am I sowing as a seed? Am I talking to somebody? Leave it alone. Stand up. No, take your seat, everybody. Take your seat. Take your seat. Don't worry. Madam, shh. Don't worry. Don't worry. Go with Mama. Go with one of my pastors. That's all. Go with Mama, one of my pastors. Take your seat. Take your seat. Don't worry. Don't worry. Take your seat. Take your seat. She has an emergency. That's why she's there. Is your name Chika? Your name is Chika. Go with them. Don't worry. Go with them. All right, am I communicating here? To search takes efforts. To search takes passion. The devil is making achievements because he is on a search. But there's something about the devil. When God speaks, even to the devil about a man, God codes it.
When he spoke about Job, God could,
do you know when God said to the devil, he said, the desire of this woman shall be upon thee. He said, the seed of the woman shall bruise thy head.
The devil did not understand who was the seed of the woman. That is why he moved on Cain to kill Abel. Because he thought Abel was going to be the seed of the woman.
God kept quiet. You see, when God wants to do something for you in 20 years' time, he will show you now as if it's tomorrow.
It was Abel.
That was the seed of the woman. So he moved on Cain, killed Abel. God kept quiet. God said, this is where you just made a mistake. He said, because what was happening there between Cain and Abel was religion. God was trying to teach us religiosity. Access to God through his own way. That was Abel. Access to God through the ways of man. That was Cain. It was a definition of religion and spirituality. Religion is self-centered. Spirituality is liberality. Religion it focuses on you, but spirituality is liberality.
And when I studied the Bible carefully, I said, Lord, to search for my throne,
what must I do? The Bible says, and Saul left his father's house.
Saul!
What was missing? Look up 1 minute. His father's asses were missing, but he could not find it in his father's house.
If you don't leave your father's house, you can't find your father's ass. Your father's asses are outside your father's houses. What does that tell you? Any man that wants to discover destiny must be disconnected from foundational operation. There are some of you looking at me now. The reason you are still struggling is because spiritually you are in your father's house. There is something that happened to others in your family that is still replacing in your life. In your family, to give birth was a crisis. To get married was a problem. And the same thing is still playing in your life now. I am making a decree by the word of the Lord. Every satanic foundation, every satanic altar, the altar of your father's house, the altar of your mother's house, that have stopped others before you. Maybe your father was polygamous and something is moving you to polygamy. Today it is broken. I say it is broken.
Hey.
It is broken.
Hey.
It is broken.
Hey.
Lift your hand, shout it. Yes.
Yeah.
Take your seat. Kanda bradaza. Konde zigish. Don't struggle. You have to look inwards. What is in my life that is a representation of my family? What is in my life that looks like my family? Do you know, if you study the Revelation, book of Revelation, the churches, 5 of the churches were sick. 1 was disqualified. Only 1 was qualified, the Philadelphia church. Now, if you chalk those 5 churches that were sick, they had internal crisis. Check all of the rebuke. It was internal. External persecution grows church. It is internal that kills church. When you say that man of God, he's using demonic power, you're advertising him. That man of God, he's not real, you're advertising him. But when the attack becomes internal, they succeed in using the wife against the husband, or using the wife against somebody, or using the husband again. Internal crisis is what kills churches, not external. Am I talking to somebody? It's in the book of Experience, chapter 5. Do you notice? If you study your Bible very well, if you run through Revelations, you discover that those 5 churches finally died. They died. Because later, when he was ending the book of Revelation, only the book, this church of Philadelphia, was what he mentioned. That's why ended the book of Revelation. All the 5 died. The one that was disqualified, that was neither cold nor hot, died. Only 1 was standing.
When you look at your life and you see certain characters, certain identity that we are in your father, that we are in your mother, that are found in your brothers,
you may cover up, but deep down you know there is something that looks like your family. You can be deceiving yourself. Say, I'm from Zion. You are from Ronigbe. You know I'm from Zion. What's Zion? I'm from Zion. I'm from Zion. You are from Uyo, Akwa Ibom. You are from Abak. I am from Zion. You know, there's so many religious jargons in the church. Yeah, the man say, bro. He say, bro, what bro? Chuku is calling himself bro. He said, I'm from Zion. I said, you're from Zion. He said, yeah. I said, okay. By the time you see challenges of life, you will run home for family deliverance. You had better attack the thing now. Am I communicating here? And I study very well. As mighty as Abraham is, do you know who Abraham was? God called Abraham my friend. And God told him, leave your father's house. If a friend of God could not rise from his father's house, you that is still standing on one leg. Am I talking to somebody? God said, he's my friend though. But we must obey principles. Leave your father's house. He said, where am I going? He said, to a land I will show you. Just go. In other words, it was in a hurry. Where are you going? To a land I will show you. But the most important thing, go.
Leave. I disconnect you from paternal connections. I disconnect you from maternal connection. What stopped your father can't stop you.
Oh, do you know what God told me while I was praying and I sensitively began to listen? Because in many of them, it appears they are laboring in vain because of wrong foundation. He said, appears they are laboring in vain because of the family they come out from. Your family is diabolic. Your family is occultic. Your family years ago had idolatry. And that is exactly what is replaying in your life now. But I'm here by the voice of God. I don't know the powers that kept your family in bondage. I don't know the powers that kept your family on the spot. I don't know the powers that kept your family in a cocoon. But I prophesy, even as God is God, with this mouth that I used to pray, you are breaking even. You are breaking even. You are breaking even. Lift your hand, shout fire.
Fire.
When you step out of your father's house, you do better than your father. You disconnect yourself from your from foundational powers. Because the asses, the Bible says, he looked for them around his father's land and could not find them. It's possible. Because if the asses were in the father's land, the father would have gotten it. You have to live your life as somebody who is on a search. You are on a search. There is something you want to find out. There are depths in the covenant. There is a mystery you want to uncover. Why don't I get satisfied? It's because I am on a search. There's something I'm looking for. There's a consciousness of ministry that there's something. There's greatness I'm looking for. Am I communicating? Something I'm looking for. There's something. It's beyond 100,000 people in the service. It's beyond getting 1 million people in the service. It's beyond the private jets. It's beyond building a university. It's beyond having churches in every continent of the world. It's beyond that. There's something I'm discovering. And it can only be enhanced by the mystery of a search. Tell somebody, get ready for research.
I can't hear you.
Sit down. You know, everyone, we are all ministers, but our pursuits our makeup actually. I was talking somewhere on one small minister's conference, one somewhere, I can't remember. Okay, some pastors came to see me. I was ministering somewhere, so they sat with me. And they said, Papa, we can, this is just 5 minutes. Can you just talk to us? So I said, okay, let me talk to you on the kinds of ministers we have. I said, number one, we have the business ministers. The business minister, everything they do is about money. Number two, you have the technology minister. They don't pray, they go to the internet, download messages. Is that true? Download things, those are the internet. They want to talk on something. If they want to preach about ego, they go to the internet, collect ego. All the words of ego. They want to talk about finances, go to internet, get all the, very easy. I said, they don't pray. They don't believe in prayer. I said, but there's something they don't know. Such ministers can't make impact because except they see signs, they will not believe. Am I talking to somebody here? And I said, there is the sick minister. The sick minister is that minister who is not well, but still preaching. There are many ministers like that. They are sick, bodily sick. They are not well. Breathing, a problem. Health, a problem. Bone, a problem. But they are still preaching and hoping it will be better. If you are in that class, you are healed. Then there are the hurting ministers. The hurting ministers, the ones that an assistant pastor has backstabbed, he traveled and left ministry for a pastor and warmed his way into the hearts of the people, and the man is crying, the man is bleeding, the woman is a pastor's wife, but she's dying inside because the husband is living without regard for conscience at all. A pastor drove his wife and they called him. Why did you drive your wife? He said, eh? When Satan rebelled in heaven, didn't God drive him? I drive her! It was structure that handled rebellion in heaven. It was administration that handled rebellion. It was Michael. God has no business. God didn't talk about it. God did not talk about it. It was administration that put the devil in his place. Am I talking to somebody here? He had a justification. There are women that are hurting. And that's why I beg all pastors, find out how happy your wife is before you preach. It's important. Are you happy? Are you fine? Are you fine? Are you okay? Are you happy? Some of you don't care. Preacher, one of the values I preach is marriage. I don't preach it. I live it. I don't preach it. I live it. Before I got to this altar, my wife, I didn't want her to hear, but you know my wife knows anything. She likes to poke nose. I'll be walking away. She wants to know what I was having an issue with a pastor and I was vibrating because I had my wife's name. And the man said, I know you don't care about criticism. Why is this one paining you? I said, because they mentioned my wife. It doesn't matter what they say about me. Say, Apostle, I am not sure you are real. It's like you are using something. You don't know. I'm using something. I'm not just only using something. Somebody is using me. Me myself, I'm a charm that somebody's using. Tying something on my waist is too small. Me, I'm a full charm. As you have seen me, somebody is using me. Am I communicating here? What have I not heard? There's nothing I've not heard. Speak against me, no problem. It's fertilizer. Young man said, how can CNN carry that kind of news about Cameroon crusade? CNN carried this and said Cameroon did this. I said, no, sir. It's my lawyer. He said, we have to sue them. And I said, why? Let's sue them. And I said, do you know what it takes to be on CNN for 7 minutes? CNN carried it. Al Jazeera carried it. BBC carried it. To be on CNN for 7 minutes is millions. And they put my story free.
I said, you want to sue them? You are against my progress.
Am I talking to somebody here?
When they criticize you, you increase.
You criticize, I increase. Am I talking to somebody here? It doesn't matter whatever is being done again. For we know that all things work together for good to them that love God and to them who are the called according to his purpose. Lift up your hands and shout hallelujah.
Watch me. Let me tell you only one thing you will do to leave your father's house. The Bible says, while he left the father's house, a servant was with him. To be on this search and encounter destiny, you must leave your father's house. But to build your father's house, you need a corporate anointing. To leave your father's house, you need a corporate anointing. If you are from a strong foundational power, from strong foundational connection, you cannot fight alone.
Let who believe and not die. Let not his man be.
He said, and he sent two. He said, go to the village. Two. Why did he send two? One came from that village, and another one was not from the village. So he has to agree with that one. There are many of you have fasted and prayed. You are yet to break out because of foundational power. I came as number two.
I came as number two. I am joining you today. If two shall agree as touching a thing, it shall be done. For out of the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word is established. I am speaking by the power of the Holy Ghost. I make a decree, standing on the word of God. One shall chase 1,000, two shall chase 10,000. I make a prophetic declaration. The evil foundation from your maternal background, your paternal background, it is broken. 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 Shut it. Yes.
Take your seat. I was in Lagos, 1999. I was in Lagos praying, and I sat down, 1999, at number two, Irebawa Street, Okeira, Ogba, Ikeja, Lagos. Sitting down, frustrated. I came, I was having an assistant, I was a resident pastor, and that day I came to the office 9 o'clock instead of coming 8 o'clock. And my senior pastor gave me punishment, and the punishment was to fast for 40 days. I see some of you now, they just shout to you, oh, have you seen discipline? Just little shout, they shout on you. You are seeing visions. Under pressure. 40 days, say I should fast. Honestly, when you want to fast 40 days willingly, it is spirituality. As a discipline, it is pressure. And I was crying. I said, what is this? I was at 98, February. And the end of February or so, mid-February, we started. I was still in the fast. I was breaking the evening. One of the days, March 12th that year, I went to a restaurant opposite the church. And somebody came to mock me. Say, hey, look at you, make him out. Didn't you hear what happened in Benin? I said, what? He said, the Archbishop is dead. That was the day the Archbishop died. I was in the midst of that fast. I couldn't break the fast. As a matter of fact, the Archbishop died. People were coming to console me as if I was a biological son because of the way I carried him on my head. My pastor was mocking me. He said, your mentor, don't die. And I sat down in the house. I was crying. And early in the morning, I saw a vision. I saw the Archbishop in the vision. He said, why are you crying? I was coming close. He said, no, don't come close to me. I said, Papa, now, if you go, where will I go? He said, you can't touch me. There is something separating us.
And I said, but you are going to say, no. There's something I've kept I want to give you. He said, it's a towel. He said, this is a towel. Take, continue. I was in the midst of a fast. And when I woke up, the Lord said, the baton has been transferred. The mantle has been transferred. And when I was in the fast, I got to 40 days. I didn't stop. I got to 50. I got to 60. My pastor said, it's okay. I told you 40. I said, I want to continue, sir. Thank you for punishing me. If you didn't punish me, I would not have gotten a mantle. I got to 100 days. And the Lord said to me, go back to a dose state. Can I say this to you here? There is a mantle that someone will contact. There is a mantle someone will contact. There is a grace someone will receive. Take it in the name of Jesus. Hey. Oh. So that's why most of the issues and the challenges I'm going through, yeah, the challenges my father went through. Criticism, being misunderstood, being fought. One time I was discouraged. I sat back, I was hearing stories. I sat back and the Archbishop walked into my room. Daddy, I was shocked. His leg didn't touch the ground. I wasn't seeing him spiritually. See, now I don't know what to call it. It wasn't spiritual, it wasn't physical, but it was not a vision. Walked into the room. I said, Johnson, why are you discouraged? What have you seen? I said, Papa, look at this. And he said to me, he said, you made it so. Don't make some mistakes that I made. I said, what? He said, don't drop political people as your friends in public. So don't make them your friends in public. Disciple them in secret. Bless them as your children. But don't identify with them publicly. If they come to you, make them your children. Don't give them special seats in church. Don't give them special honor. Don't give them... Many times I've seen certain things happen. He will come. He will tell me. He will say, see. Do it this way. Say, this is what I did that I should not have done. He said, do it this way. Do it. And the last one that shocked me, I was on my way to Cameroon. I was praying. And the Lord showed me the vision of Cameroon. Showed me what was going to happen. We have not seen anything, no. No, we have not seen, no. No, what the Lord showed. No, I'm serious. Mark, if you follow this grace, everything I've said, watch it. They happen. Everything. And the Lord said to me, he said, this is this. And obviously, the Archbishop came. And the Lord said to me, through the Archbishop, he said, Johnson, we are counting on you. He didn't say I. He said, we are counting. He said, don't be in a hurry to be at rest. He said, one of the things that have killed many great men is early relaxation. No, not satisfaction. Relaxation. You are just relaxed at a tiny achievement. Don't be jealous of what you see happening around here. I contacted a man too. That is not even making me physically look like him. It's a mantle here. Take your seat. You study your Bible. In the book of Judges, the Bible says, he said, five kings rose up against Gibeon. They didn't rise up against Joshua. They rose up against Gibeon. Why? At that time, Joshua had destroyed Ai. And Gibeon, the Gibeonites, were afraid of being destroyed. So they entered a peace treaty willingly with Joshua. And Gibeon was a choice land. So these kings got angry. And they ganged up against Ai, against Gibeon. What does it mean? Joshua destroyed Ai and Gibeon came on their own. Joshua destroyed Ai, Gibeon came. What is Ai? Ai means waster. What is Gibeon? Choice land given willingly. So if you can waste the waster, the choice land will be given willingly. 5 kings came. 5. What's the name of the first king? Adonizedek. Adonizedek means a backup. Now, watch this.
Now, they came against Gibeon
because Gibeon made peace treaty with Israel. They were not after Joshua. They were after those who made peace treaty. Can I shock you? There are many people who make up their minds to bless you. They are being fought because of you. They are being fought because they are partners. They are helpers of your assignment.
The very period they said to you,
let's see how we can put galleries and roof the church and do this, their finances we attack.
It is because Gibeon has been attacked, because they made peace treaty. And that is why sometimes you've got to pray for your helpers. You've got to pray for those who are connected to you. Because when your helpers are attacked, your ministry is a mockery. When your helpers are attacked, struggle continues. When your helpers are attacked, pain
continues. And hear what happened. The Bible says, Adonizedek led the campaign. Adonizedek means a backup. For everyone that is confronting you today, there is a backup. A backup. You are useless without a backbone. Hello? Your backup. Everything that looks like a confrontation, there is a backup. But let me prophesy. By the power of the Holy Ghost, no matter the backup of your enemies, God will frustrate them. Take your seat.
How
do I search for my throne? Number one, leave your father's house. Number two, you must be a son. A what? A real son. Or a daughter. But in the kingdom of God, when you just get born again, you are a son, you are a daughter. But when you have grown, there is no daughter. You are all sons. At infancy stage, come out from among them and be separate, and you shall become my sons and daughters. That is when you are just saved. But once you are now full of the Spirit, as many as are led by the Spirit, they are the sons. There's no daughter there. They are the sons. At beginning stage, there is gender. At maturity, there is son. Because actually, God is not seeing you when you mature. He's seeing Christ. So he's not seeing you. Once you mature, he's not seeing you as a person. He's seeing Christ. That is why he becomes the son of God. Am I communicating here?
When the father discovered his asses were missing,
he didn't call any other person than a son. Are you a son? Are you a son? Are you a true son?
A child is born,
but a son is given. Isaiah 9 verse 6. A son is one who has given himself. See, I donate myself for what I believe. Not my hand, not my leg. Myself. My life. A son is given. Unto us a child is born, and a son is given. Is given.
Sons!
So if you are a lady, you are a son.
Sons are those who can die for what they believe.
I told you the story of a king who sent a emissary to another king and said, in 21 days I will come and take over your nation from you. So prepare the documents, prepare everything, and I'm coming to take over your nation. He sent his personal assistant to that land. He said, go and tell that king I'm coming to take over his nation. When the personal assistant got there, he saw the king. The king said, what did he say? He says, he's coming to take over your territory. The king said, wait. The king called a soldier. He said, come, go to that mountain. The soldier climbed. The king said, fall down and die. The soldier released himself, died, broke his skull. The king said, come, and said, take that sword, pierce it through your heart. The soldier carried the sword and pierced it to his heart. He said, now go to the river. There are crocodiles. Jump in. The PA of the other king saw This man jumped into the pond and crocodiles began to tear him. The PA was shaking. He said, go back and tell your boss, I have 3,000 men like that who are ready to die. Tell him to come. Tell him to come. When the PA got back, he told the king, he said, what did you see? He said, look for another country. He said, see what? He said, the man used three people to show me experiment when war has not started. He said, because, sir, we are not ready to take those risks. Those men took. He said, look for another country. Leave that. That is a son who is ready to die. We tell somebody I'm not a bastard. I want to say that with all sense of consciousness. I'm not a bastard. I want to say this to you, and I will stand to prove it. When anybody walks into a commission or a ministry, and after a while walks out, it was never a son. John 8:35. A son abided forever. After a while, I feel I'm saying, you were never a son. You were hired. You were an hireling. Some people see certain ministries as a transit point. Let me understudy from here, know how, and get platform. You think you are smarter than protocols of destiny? You think you are smarter than laws? You think you are smarter than destiny structures? It will hook you. It will hook you. Say, let me just study ministry here, know some things, get some platform, make some name, and after that, go ahead. A young man was a member, prayer band member, and he started the church in town. I didn't know he was still in town until some days ago. I heard he was saying so many nonsense about me, and I kept quiet about it. And one young man in this church who went there, stayed for a while, found out this didn't look like Papa. Came back, he got angry. He said he was going to lock up the young man for saying things about him. That's when I spoke. I said, then I'll lock you up. I want you to feel what it means to speak about people. I said, don't leave him. I said, one has just started, there are many coming. Because don't let anybody deceive you that you reap what you sow. You don't reap what you sow, you reap more than what you sow. You can. Am I communicating? When the Bible says what you sow, you shall reap. It means you reap the same species of what you sow. Not the same quantity. You can't sow one seed of corn and reap a seed of corn. You reap. So if you speak against a grace and you decide, please, if you speak against a grace, make sure you don't attempt to be a grace yourself. You are speaking against pastor. Make sure you are in business. I'm not a pastor. Because even in that business, they will still ruin you. Never listen to anybody who has left a commission because he has nothing good to say. If anybody has left a commission, say, I want to say something, say, I don't want to hear. Because he will speak to defend himself. How can you be in a place for 5 years and later you discover it is evil? 5 years, you were blind? Am I communicating here? A son abided forever. The first characteristic of a son is that a son stays forever. The second characteristic of a son is that a son takes up assignments. The father said, go and look for asses. I have certain ministers and pastors who work with us. When they come on any major program like this, the first they ask, Papa, what assignment? What can we do? Any assignment for the boys? What do we do? Tell us what to do. When I sit back and I see my pastors ministering, being blessed, I have butterflies in my tummy. I am excited. I am happy. Sometimes I sit in their car. I sit well. I just call all the AC. I say, this is fruit of my labor. Ah.
I said, Father, thank you. Thank you. Why will I be angry?
What?
Father, thank you. I said, I'm happy.
I'm happy. I'm happy.
And as I said, when did you get this one? Say, sometime. I say, ah. Oh. Then when I'm passing anywhere, even those people don't see me, I say, how are you? It's my son.
That's my joy.
Am I communicating? When your children grow, it gives you pride. My first daughter and I, we talk like friends now. We don't, not father and daughter again, no. We talk like friends. I'll say something, she'll say, no, that's not right. It's like this. I say, sorry. Have another one that will argue with me. I say, that's the thing in English called soliloquy. Say, what is soliloquy? I say, I didn't say it with that accent. I said soliloquy. I'm from Auchi. That, no, that's too fake. Say it like this, soliloquy. I say, go and meet your mother. Fast!
Am I communicating here? Please, sir!
Understand the mystery of sonship. Assignment. What are you doing, or how are you doing what you have been sent to do? Do you mix up an assignment with your own assignment? I tell pastors, I say, when you are posted to a place, you are sent to sell a drug. Sell the drug, not yourself. Let them know you are a vendor. Just keep doing what you are doing. I say, at the end of the day, have you discovered anytime Joshua comes to a brick wall, he remembers his Moses? And the spirit of his Moses comes upon him. Am I communicating?
A true son
is a giver. He gives his time. He gives himself. Oh, can I show you something from the Bible? Look at this 1 minute, everybody. In Luke, the book of Luke chapter 18, you remember the story of the rich young ruler? Do you remember? The rich young ruler came to Jesus. He said, what shall I do that I might not get eternal life? Inherit. As far as was concerned, he wanted an eternal life among his cars and his building. He wanted as an inheritance that I shall inherit eternal life. Jesus began to say, okay, have you done this? Have you done that? Love thy neighbor as thyself. Do this. And guess what he said? He said, I've done all that since I was a youth. That was sarcastic. Is that true? That was a sarcastic response. If you are told, love your neighbor, love yourself, do, it's okay. I think I do that. No, he said, since I was a boy. In other words, what you are saying is old fashioned. I've passed that level. That's not, I was a child and I was doing all that. Jesus said, okay, go and sell your things and give to the poor. Even after an encounter with Jesus, somebody left sorrowful. Jesus. But yeah, Jesus, that was chapter 18. The next was chapter 19. A man called Zacchaeus. Jesus did not even encounter or talk with him. He just said, come down, I'm going to your house. I said, Lord, this look pasha. You spoke with one in discussion and he still left sorrowful. You have not even spoken with another. You were going to his house. He climbed a tree and maybe probably was there with monkeys. Who climbs tree? And he appointed him. He didn't just say, hey, you come down. Could have said, hey, you come down. If he said, hey, you come down, many monkeys. So he said, Zacchaeus, oh, Zacchaeus, come down. Mention his name. And the man came down. And I said, why? You went to his house. The Lord said to me, finish his story. I finished his story. He said, all I have taken from the poor, I will give back. And God said, one came, left empty. I saw one, I was attracted because one had a giving spirit.
No matter how many years
you stay around the altar, if you are not a giver, you don't get profit from the altar.
Serving God without sacrifice is charismatic affliction. temple being anointed with oil without an open hand is witchcraft and religious enchantment. You must understand that what makes a man stand strong.
How can you come to a place like this? Like this. You see unction at work and you walk away like that. I've never done that. I've never done that in my life. A car was brought for me. It was a Phantom Rolls Royce. Several millions. I just sat in the car in Lagos. When they cleared it, I sat in the car. I looked at it. God said to me, turn it around. Straight to water. And I told them, I said, send this thing to water. They said, eh. I said, let them send it. I won't go with it. Lest I change my mind. Before you get to Songo, just say, you know what? Reverse first. Let me confirm. It went there. And I called God's servant. I said, I just dropped this seed. He said, oh boy, where did you get that one? I said, it was just a leading. Speak over my life. And he said, I told you before that what took us years will take you months. He said, I told you that before. I said, yes, sir. He said, that word still stands. Am I communicating here? Am I communicating under this kind of unction? Sir, the easiest way to duplicate the unction you desire is by being crazy in the school of sacrifice. When I mean sacrifice, I mean something that looks like the grace that you expect. My wife, I love my wife. I just love my wife. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. Because some kind of sacrifice I've given, it takes a woman that loves God that we allow the husband to release it. When I just say, God says, you can tell, I will look at her face. Hey, he said, go ahead. Sometimes she will come to me and say, let's give this. By the time she's talking, it's several millions upon millions upon millions. Take your seat.
Why?
Because there's something I see. And I've told pastors all the time, anything you give, you outgrow. You want to be bigger than a car? Let it go. You want to be bigger than a building? Let it go. You want to be bigger than millions? Let it go. You become bigger than it. Am I communicating here? A son cares for the feelings of his father. He said, and Saul said, let me return. Let my father worry it for me. A son cares. A son is bothered for the feelings of the father. Number three. To search for your throne, Libra Gadash, you must find your prophet.
Now watch this. If you study your Bible, you discover it was after a long search
that Saul found his prophet. Prophets sent to you are found. You search for them and find them. They are not imposed. They are discovered. Nobody walks up to you and say, from today I'm your father. Tell him, no! Let me find my father. I want to ask a question. Why is it that these days in the church, people do not call new converts sons and daughters? It's already made people. We pastors, we don't call new converts. That occult boy that was a cultist, yes, they say he's my son. No, you're ashamed to display before the world. You look for one guy who has arrived. That's a son. Prophets are discovered. True prophets are people who you find out. Listen to me. His father's house, the throne, the prophet. The father's house, the throne, the prophet. So the prophet is the link between your foundation and your destiny.
The link between your foundation and your assignment and your destiny
is your prophet. There are many of us who are submitting to headless heads. Can I repeat that? If you have a mentor, who is his mentor? I was privileged one day to be around my father and the Lord, and I said, I want to ask a question. So what is it? I said, Daddy, you know your church, this world, your work is all over the world. I said, yes. Sorry, sir. Who do you pay tithe to? At least let me know where my destiny is going. I know my own stops with you, but you. Sorry, sir. Ah, he laughed. You know, he doesn't talk too much. He said, do you know the kind of money that comes here?
It's for missionaries.
I said, hey, okay. And he said, do you know what comes from just a region? Another, he says, billions upon billions. All missionaries around are on salary. Every month. Sometimes I don't even see the tithe. I said, okay. I needed to know if my future was secured. Headless head paying tithe to a non-giver is to truncate your finances. Outline a man who has left his wife to lay hands on your head to prophesy on you, and you sit down, you are saying amen to that kind of prayer. How much I was communicating. And God began to talk to me. God said, when you find your prophet, you have found your throne. When you find your prophet, you have found your throne. Who is your prophet? Look at the definition of the prophet there. Two definitions. I like that. You know the first definition? He said, for he cometh into town, and the people will not eat until he comes. So your prophet is one that until he eats, you are not permitted to eat. It's not your Bible. So if you are here and you are a son of the prophet, until I've eaten, you see how African you have become. But that's what the Bible says. Is you know what I do? You know what I do? I see a shoe. I say, hey, this shoe will be good for my father. Now, what am I doing? Now, I don't need shoes, oh. Don't get me wrong. I'm telling you the lifestyle, the mentality that I have. This should be good. There's no father that you can't see when you hold something right. I'm telling you by experience. I can see my father in the Lord 20 times a day. Let me just carry something that looks like something. One day I sent a text to somebody to send to Baba. Baba does not read text. He doesn't send text. So I said, I want to see. They travel. They don't run. As I'm coming with a seat, so and so. Are you coming in the morning or in the evening? It's anytime that day I'm coming. Now, are they greedy? No! It only shows how serious you are. What will you give to that man that doesn't have? What will you give to him that he does not have? A man of God, great father like that, bought an aircraft, and pressmen were crying that he bought an aircraft, and he replied them that he's looking for a bigger one. And I said, I'm coming with this. I'm letting you know that the proof of value is sacrifice. I connect to grace. You will confess and yet not connect. Connection and value is on the platform of sacrifice. I don't know about any other prophet or father, but I know I'm very fertile. Why I'm fertile is that what I say is what I do. One of the things that helps you as a preacher to be a fertile ground is what you are saying. Make sure that's what you are doing. You preach sacrifice, do sacrifice. I've seen practical change happen right in front of me. Practical change right in my eyes. I was in this office. A young man came. A lady came. The husband came with her. And the elder sister came with her and the husband. So when I was telling her what the Lord said to me to tell her, she now says, "Sir, I don't know. I'm sorry. I should not have done this. But my sister's husband, they are here." I said, "Okay." So they came. I said, "Young man, what can I do for you?" He said this, I said that, I work with this, I work with that. They have abandoned me, they forgot about me for years, they won't call me. I said, "Okay, give me your hand. Let them remember you now." He said, "Amen." And he was still standing. I said, "Go." He said, "Is that all?" I said, "Yes." I could see defeat. He just looked at me. "Please sit down." He just looked, sit down, take your seat. He just looked at me and he turned away and he walked away. As he went to sit down, I was talking with someone else. I saw him less than 2 minutes. He screamed. He stood up. He showed the wife a text. "Send your full names. The way it appears on your CV, your appointment letter is out." The same people he had not heard from for years. He said, "Wait. Is this how?" That number two. Another came. One of them said, "Yeah, growth the neck." I said, "Come bring it." Disappear. In Jesus' name. She went back. Ah! Come, say, "Touch it." That one touch. I saw crowd. They were touching neck. They were, and I said, "What's going on?" He said, "I can't find it." I said, "There is an unction here that is alive and well. There is a grace in this place that is alive and well. I see someone's connection bringing strange testimonies. I see someone's connection bringing shocking testimonies." If that amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking to. Amen. If that amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking to. Amen. God is about to disconnect thousands of us from foundational limitations. Your father could not build a house and you want to build a church. You think it's a joking matter? Your father could not buy land and you are struggling to buy. I see you not just living in a house of your own. I see the house becoming the envy of your world. Amen. The unction for properties is strong here. The unction for properties, the Lord Jesus himself, by the spirit of grace, the Bible says, the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. I am making a bold declaration over lives and over destiny right here, that by reason of this contact you are getting this day, that the anointing for your own properties shall be manifested in your life. Amen. Rise up on your feet. Two things I want to do. I want to pray and disconnect people from foundations. Are you ready? Bogo bala kabadasa, monti kilosi brashi, ombokotia kapatas. You see, they say a father had diabetes, a mother had diabetic, even a pastor is not having diabetes. The same struggles of human life. The same struggle. Lift up your right hand. Foundational issues, the way they are handled is that you must first reject it. That is how it works. You must first reject it. And I want you not, don't pray like a pastor. Pray like a Christian. Don't pray here like a pastor. Don't pray like somebody here who oversees a church. Pray like somebody who wants himself to be delivered. Don't pray like a preacher here. Am I communicating here? Don't pray like somebody who is leading prayer. There are pastors who are even in their closet, they pray as if they are leading prayer. In the closet, he's praying like somebody leading prayer. Lift your right hand up and take this after me. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Uh-huh.
Lift up your right hand of fire.
Say, my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
As I pray.
As I pray.
Any connection.
Any connection.
That has my umbilical cord.
That has my umbilical cord.
Matana patana.
Matana patana.
In the realm of the spirit.
In the realm of the spirit.
As I pray.
As I pray.
I am disconnected. Open your mouth and
disconnect.
Shut up.
Where do you live? Yes. Yes. Stay there. Uh-huh. Stay there. Where do you live?
Uh-huh.
Eh? They brought you back from Europe? Were you in Europe before? They brought you back.
Yes, I was in Europe before, in Madrid. They brought me back.
They brought you back.
Yes.
Come. You know him? You know, God gives second chances, but no third chance.
Je te donne nouvelle chance.
God gives second chance. But what?
But no third chances.
You didn't glorify God. Do you understand me? Do you understand me?
Yes.
You did not glorify God.
It's true.
When you were, you say it's true. I'm not asking you. I'm telling you. When you were living in Europe, you did not glorify God.
C'est une mauvaise vie.
But now you make up your mind. The life you live there is a life that the devil capitalized upon to put you in what you went through. But now I'm seeing you on your way for another one now, so you can travel. Alright?
Tu vas rentrer?
I'm seeing you preparing to go and get a visa.
I went there yesterday. I was rejected.
That's what I'm saying. You are going to get a visa. That's what I'm saying God doing for you. You don't want it?
I want it. I want to go back. My family, they are still there. My wife.
You had a family and you were doing what I'm seeing you do. You have your wife and a son?
Son. My wife, she's still pregnant now.
Now?
She's pregnant now.
She's your wife, you're married to her?
I've not paid her.
You're not married to her? Huh? Are you married?
No.
Who is Robert?
Robert.
Like Eze.
Eze.
What's your name?
Comment t'appelles?
Hein?
Robert Eze.
I'm surrounded by your love.
Hallelujah. Everlasting love. Should I feel what me?
Can I talk to you? Can I pray about your family? Can I pray about your family?
Yes, please.
I saw healing coming on you. Healing.
You
need healing.
Yes.
You are not well. And God wants to heal you.
Yes.
And God, I also see something about your family. Your family is scattered.
Yes.
Scattered.
Yes.
Everyone scattered.
That's why I come.
Huh?
That's why I come.
Come.
Viens.
I don't know the English to speak. Come.
You have been a minister of God. A pastor.
Un pasteur.
For 25 years.
Depuis 25 ans.
Yes, sir.
How long?
Yes, sir. I've been a minister for the past 25 years.
Ministry, you suffered.
Dans le mystère,
when you started,
quand tu as commencé,
you were with a ministry.
Yes, sir.
Just some years ago,
yes, là quelques années,
you began your own.
Yes, sir.
Tu as commencé pour toi.
I don't know what is this something or half or half or half or something. I see. Okay,
Ihamufu.
Enugu State. You want to work for God among your people?
Yes, sir. God sent me to my place. I was in Kano when God called me, and he told me he was sending me to my
place. How do I know you are from that place?
By the revelation of God.
Your people,
des gens,
because staying outside,
rester à l'extérieur,
your people,
des gens,
the attacks we are getting to you,
attack,
even when you were where you were,
and quand tu
coming from the house,
dans la maison,
they killed your wife,
yes, sir.
You married another woman,
yes, sir.
The first wife had three.
La première
three children, two boys and a girl.
This present wife,
la deuxième,
is Deborah.
Deborah, yes.
On her left side, there's a growth like fibroid.
Yes, sir.
She has fibroid.
Yes.
Elle a un fibron.
Now,
maintenant,
I'm entering your church now.
J'entre dans ton église.
Last Sunday,
dimanche passé,
you were 20 something.
Tu étais quelque chose.
Very small.
Very, very small.
And that 20 something is almost like 8 children.
C'est comme 8 enfants.
8 children.
8 enfants.
19 adults.
19.
19 adults is 12 women, 7 men.
12 femmes et 7 hommes.
Don't cry. 25 years.
25 années.
25. God wants to pay you arrears.
Je vais te payer tes arrières.
God wants to pay you arrears.
Je vais payer tes arrières.
God wants to pay you arrears. Who has a lady? You have Gabriel among your name. You are a lady.
Tu es une femme?
I'm seeing you around Kaduna. I don't know if it's Kaduna State.
Kaduna.
There's Gabriel among your name.
Et Gabriel parmi ton nom.
What's your name?
Comment t'appelles?
Hein? What's your name?
Felicia Gabriel.
From where?
Kaduna.
Are you a minister?
Petit ministre.
Are you a minister?
Yes, a pastor.
Pride is a killer.
Okay.
You know they call pride?
Okay.
You know they call pride? Pride is a killer.
C'est un meurtrier.
Pride is a killer. Pride is a killer.
L'orgueil tue.
Pride is a killer. The Lord,
le Seigneur,
used me in your dream.
M'a utilisé dans ton rêve.
And told you to come.
Yes,
and see me.
Yes, sir.
You didn't want to come.
Tu as refusé.
You were stubborn. Pride.
More than 4 years.
More than 4 years.
Yes, sir.
Pride.
L'orgueil.
You asked few questions, you heard some things.
Tu as des choses?
You heard things, you were discouraged, you were waiting, you kept seeing the revelation. Saying,
I keep on seeing you and mama every day.
Do you see pride?
Well, okay.
Come.
Viens.
Your coming is for your good.
Tu es venu pour ton bien.
Sir.
Monsieur.
You come here in March.
Tu es venu ici en mars.
When you are in this minister's conference in March.
J'étais ici la conférence des hommes de Dieu.
The testimony you will have.
Le témoignage que tu auras.
People will ask.
Les gens demanderont.
Did you get yourself involved in something?
Est-ce que tu es entré quelque part?
This is not about ritual. It's about being spiritual.
Le rituel, c'est l'être spirituel.
The God of heaven, my Father.
Le Dieu de mon Père.
Abba Father. Restore his wasted years.
Restaure ses années perdues.
Your failures will become strength.
Tes faiblesses deviendront tes forces.
Your pain will become gain.
Ta douleur deviendra le gain.
Your shame will become fame.
Deviendront
fresh oil.
Un feu nouveau.
In Jesus' name. There is a son.
Un fils.
There is a son.
Il y a un fils.
That has a problem.
Un
that
problème
I want to pray about.
Que tu as prié.
I'm talking of your son. Who is making noise there? What? What's the problem?
Quel est le problème?
He's blind.
Il est aveugle.
Eh? Stay there, stay there. Leave him
Resta.
There. Who is he?
Qui est-il?
Who are you?
Qui es-tu?
I'm here. You know him?
Yes, he's a friend that is the father of a friend.
Calm down. What's the matter? Put the mic in his mouth.
I need my sight.
Where are you from?
D'où viens-tu?
I'm from Anambra State.
What's your name?
Comment t'appelles?
Pastor Emmanuel Ibanogo.
You're a pastor?
Yeah, I'm a pastor for about 25 years now. But since 2009, this attack started.
Wait, sir, the attack is not a problem. You've been a pastor. What area are you in Anambra? What area? What area? Where do you live?
I'm living at Onitsha now.
Where in Onitsha?
Under National Evangelical Commission.
You're under National Evangelical Commission?
Yes.
So how long have you lost your sight?
Become the learning.
Since 2000 and
you know him?
7 2007.
He's your father. Come.
Then my wife and my children, all of them were here with me now.
He's your father. So
my mom cannot walk.
Your mom cannot walk and your father is blind. Where's your mom?
Ta mom peut pas marcher.
She can't walk.
Elle peut marcher.
She's been having diabetes.
Wait, give me your hand.
De ma ta main.
Pick her up.
Qu'est-ce que c'est?
Oh, yes. Come.
Reviens.
Stand up.
Lève-toi.
Healing anointing will come upon you from today.
Les soins de guérison vont tomber sur toi.
Go and tell that woman to walk. Go. Go and show me your mother.
Va dire à cette femme de se lever.
Go and touch the woman. Let her stand up.
Qu'est-ce que lève et qu'elle marche?
Now.
Maintenant.
The healing power has already
been
released. You are great, yes, you are. Holy One. You walk upon the sea, you raise the dead. You reign in majesty.
You reign in majesty.
Mighty Lord,
everything I think about
you is great.
Is she walking?
You are great. Yes.
Is she walking? She's walking. She's walking. Hey!
You walk upon the sea.
You walk upon the sea and raise the dead.
Awesome Jesus. Halabrodos. Leboro sekeleba. Melebo shandalabas.
Everything written about you.
Melebos.
Is great.
You are 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 great.
Everything written about you is great.
The Greek meaning for the Greek word for hope is epis. Epis means a confident expectation.
Ça veut dire une attente de confiance.
Not just an expectation that is built on confidence.
Une attente qui est enracinée dans la confiance.
In this place, healing happens cheaply.
Because
it's not man, it's God.
Parce que c'est pas un homme, c'est Dieu.
Papa.
Papa.
You will see now.
Vous verrez maintenant.
Hallelujah.
You believe?
Tu crois?
Father, thank you.
Merci, Père.
I know that this is unto your glory. I know that thou hearest me always.
C'est que tu m'entends toujours.
But that this standing might know
afin que les gens connaissent
that the kingdom of God is not in word but in power.
Pas en parole, mais en puissance.
Let there be a practical demonstration.
Une démonstration pratique.
I rebuke blindness.
Je réprimande l'aveuglement.
I decree that the powers that have taken the sight, their assignment is terminated.
Sa mission est finie.
Eyes! Ah!
Que ses yeux s'ouvrent.
Receive your sight right now.
Maintenant.
In Jesus' name.
Au nom de Jésus.
Heaven and earth adore you.
Hallelujah.
You know, Uno, you're together. Who she to you?
The
pastor. I saw.
J'ai vu.
Do I know you before?
Est-ce qu'on se connaît?
Have I met you before?
No.
Did you discuss with anybody?
No.
You had a child.
Vous avez un enfant.
That killed himself.
C'est tu?
Yes.
Your child killed himself.
Yes.
There's a spirit of suicide.
Yes.
In your family.
Yes.
Little thing, they want to die.
Yes.
Little thing,
yes.
They want to die.
So dans la mort.
And I want to pray. I want to break it. The spirit of suicide, so that you don't lose your children and even the ones who are alive and not together, fighting among themselves.
Yes.
Because of that, your blood pressure is high and now you're sick. Hold it. Madam, drop this picture. This is another problem. Better hold it.
Let's take a photo.
Father,
Père,
change our story.
Change son histoire.
It's over.
C'est fini.
Look at that. Look at that. Look at that.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. What is wrong with pastors? Celebrate Jesus. Young lady.
Hallelujah.
Young lady. Wait, wait.
Attends.
You are looking there. Your father can see. Go and meet your father.
Glory, glory.
I
Are you just looking like that? Are you looking? Lift your hands. Are you here to be a spectator? Are you here to be a spectator?
There's going to be deposits.
You're in depot.
Same unction. Same grace. Same anointing. Same anointing. Gebolo kamasaka polorosa. Libroko shikete baragadoze. Ligliso, ligliso, ligliso. Father,
Père,
I decree.
Je décrète.
Now, what? The daughter is crying. Thank you. I just had a whisper. God said to tell you. But what's about to be downloaded on you now? What all that struggle to get in years will happen to you in months.
Amen.
You know, I was about making a statement and it just paused me. With what has happened, I wanted to pray for a healing anointing and I just had him say no, speed.
La vitesse.
Father, lift your hands upon everyone, servant of God, right here,
ici,
or watching by way of television,
television
all over the world,
partout dans le monde entier,
the unction for speed come upon you. Please, here, stretch your hand to me, all of you. Hold it together and stretch it. This roll, wherever I see the wind, that's where I direct prayers though. That roll, to the back, to the top. Stretch it to me. Father, open it like this. Let it open, yeah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I release the same anointing on my life, on my ministry, on my private and personal life that has enjoyed speed in every aspect of their life. Let it be duplicated in the name of Jesus. One, let it come. Two, let it come. Three, I decree, as all of you directly opposite me now, hold hands together, lift it up, up the gallery, even the ground floor, do the same thing, hold hands together, lift it up, up the gallery. My God, Paul prayed with his God. He said, my God shall supply. He knew his God. I pray with my God. All of you there, only the hungry shall be filled. And they'll be filled by what they hunger for. Father, I take from my head a portion of the unction of speed upon somebody on the ground floor, on the gallery. One, two, three. Fresh fire upon your life. I rebuke. I saw the anointing, the prophetic anointing coming upon your life and your assignment. Prophetic anointing. I saw the prophetic anointing. Lika pamala satash. Monde koso braheka. Blendo lodosha. Iribala kasasa. Cameraman, don't be too close to me. Don't be too close to me. Le mondo zobahe. Li calabra sila dasa. Li rabaka koto brodosh. Raka paka palata tapaka. Mota paka saki posh. Father, thank you. Take it!
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Le blashada. Father, thank you. I release the anointing of God upon you. Open their eyes to see. Their ears to take it in Jesus' name.
the name of Jesus. Take it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Lika barasa
da da ba ba ba. Leave Osha. Oh. Father, release the anointing for projects. There shall be projects. Take it in the name of Jesus. There shall be projects. Anointing for projects. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Take it in the name of Jesus. Come here. Fresh fire. Stay by your seat. I can come. You will hear from God like a man hear from his friend. Take! Jeremiah. In the name of Jesus. Fresh! Pick, I can come. Anointing for miracles that can't be argued. Raise the dead. Raise the dead. Fresh!
What you have done, Lord, what you will do.
Fresh!
We give you all the praise, all the glory.
Fresh!
To you,
fresh!
Lord. What you have done, God.
Father, release the anointing. Take it in Jesus' name. Fresh fire. Fresh! In the name of Jesus. Fresh anointing. Fresh anointing. Fresh. Fresh. Fresh.
Give you all the praise. All the glory belongs to you. For what you have done, God. For what you will do.
Father. Who is Lawrence? Edge. 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 What's your name? Where are you based? Eh?
Oju.
Who is the woman that is scattering your name? I saw a woman that is,
yes sir,
going to people that you are fake.
Yes sir.
That you are not true. You are fake.
Yes sir. Yes sir.
A woman, not a man.
Yes sir.
Is telling people that you are fake.
Yes sir.
What's your business with her?
I don't have any business. She was a member before, but she has left. Before she left, she used bike, bought food, and started going to members as one by one.
She was going to, eh? It's true?
Yes sir.
Who knows about it? You know. He was going, she bought fuel.
Yes, sir.
On the bike. I was going one by one.
Yes, sir.
To the house of members.
Yes, sir.
I was telling them what?
I was telling them that that before, because they gave me land in Makurdi and I opened church, that it was somebody I pregnanted in Oju. That was why I ran away and I'm around. Me and my family were in Oju. We only opened branch for another person to come up.
Now, she has done damage, though. What I've seen, she has done damage.
Yes, sir.
She has done
very
damage
well,
because
sir.
What I see, in as much as we can pray, but you have to be very careful because this was somebody you trusted.
Yes,
she
sir.
She was somebody you trusted.
Yes,
you, sir. The reason people believe her is because you see this woman you married, she was even seeing the signs and telling you,
yes, sir,
to be careful of this person.
Yes, sir.
But as a man, you said, no, don't worry. I know how to handle this. I know. And now, what's covenant confidence?
Yes, that's my children. Covenant is the boy, confidence is the girl.
Hallelujah. The damage that this lady has caused, because now what I'm seeing now is they are trying to set you up. This set up is something that you will try to deny and not be able to. Somebody will come out like and stand and hold a child. You'll be wondering, me? Where? Me? Where? And even then, the woman who loves you as your wife will start asking you questions that tell me the truth. And you say, but there's nothing like that. This is a pure setup. Somebody will be paid. And the person will walk into a church on a Sunday. Don't cry. What is revealed is redeemed.
in the name of Jesus. The gospel was made for people to go to heaven, but since they refuse to go to heaven, we send them to hell.
Amen.
God said, I should tell you, he will shut our mouth permanently.
Amen.
Surprising. 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 Who's Gladys? Who's Gladys?
S'appelle Gladys.
Why is he crying?
Pourquoi pleure?
He's blind. Bring him here.
All
right. Stop there. I'll come pray for you there. Stop crying. Stop crying. Stop crying. Who's Gladys? From Barcelona. Like Spain, I don't know. Is it Barcelona or Patlona?
Barcelona.
I want the women to get ready tonight because everything about this night is for the women. Prayer for nations, everything, and Mama will be preaching. Mama is ministering tonight. It's about them. It's about them tonight. What's your name? Where are you from? You are from Pamplona. You are from where? Delta. Aka.
Gladys Raphael Aka.
Aka.
Hallelujah.
Why are you surprised? It took you time to come out. Come this way. Oh, this doesn't happen there. So it looks like a movie to you. They're shaking. Why are you shaking? Calm down.
Messiah is the Lord of Lords.
Messiah is the King of Kings.
Hallelujah. There's no money.
Il n'y a pas d'argent.
I see John.
John.
John. It's John.
John.
Nothing. Now you are. Non. It has come so bad that you are even thinking of a job. A job. See, I need to do something. I need to do something because of the way things are. But God is going to change your story.
Je changerai ton histoire.
And the story of your husband. Who is Joshua?
S'appelle Joshua.
My second to the last.
Jeremiah.
My last born.
Who is Ruth?
My second child.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
You are returning here by next year. And there will be in Europe a property that you would have bought with your money. Amen. Between now and then.
Amen.
So much money.
Amen.
So much favor.
Amen.
So much supply.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I want to pray. tell you about him? He needs healing. He needs healing, healing. Healing. And God is bringing it now. In Jesus' name. You, who says he wants to see? Is he blind then? I can't come there. I can't come there. You want to see? Look at me. Hey, look at me. Look at me. Leave her. Leave her. Leave her. Stay there. Stay there. Hold her. Don't fall. You. Where is she going? Hold her. Stand in front of her there, Usher. Usher. Stand in front of her. Lady, put your two hands on your eyes. Put your two hands.
Mettez deux mains sur tes yeux.
You see that one that I want to see? The lady there. Two of them.
Les deux.
One, two, what?
And two.
I know, there's one here, right? Who else? Please, I can't. Can you bring them here? I can't come there, please. No, Felix, let them come. I can't come there. I want to round up. This is 2 o'clock. Calm down, calm down. All right, stop there. Stop there, madam. Stop. Who else? Who else? Put your hand to. Put your hand on your eye.
Madam,
another you. One. Bring down. Why are ministers so... Let them put their hands on their eyes. Adjust Baba's suit. Adjust Baba's suit. Thank you, Father.
Merci, Père.
Oh God, you are your Lord. Oh God, you are your Lord. Agbara kan toma ogoni. Oh God, you are your Lord.